Hello everyone, myself Rashmi TN. Today in this session, we'll discuss and we'll justify whether green IT is a burden or an opportunity.
Before discussing or before justifying whether it is a burden or an opportunity, we'll first have a recap of the enterprise green strategy which we had discussed in the previous session. Then we'll have a discussion on the burden or opportunity feature of the green IT. Then we'll have a small assessment with few multiple choice questions and descriptive questions. So in the last session, we discussed about various IT strategies that an enterprise or an organization can use in order to green the infrastructure which they have used. So the driving force for an enterprise to carry out greening of its infrastructure or greening of its IT are: the first one is self-interest, second one social, cultural and political influence, third one is industry and business pressures, fourth one would be regulatory and compliance requirements, fifth one is environmental concerns, and the last one would be the economic savings. So if we make use of green IT, what are the benefits that we get? So the benefits that we get using green IT are: it will actually improve the energy efficiency, that is, the energy cost will get reduced as less energy is consumed. It will also lower the greenhouse gas emissions and the carbon footprint. Since the amount of energy consumption gets reduced, the amount of greenhouse gas emission will also considerably reduce, leading to a decrease in the carbon content in the atmosphere. It will actually encourage the reuse and the recycling, that will actually reduce the manufacturing cost and proper management of the toxic materials like lead, mercury, cadmium, chromium that are actually contained in the IT hardware. It reduces the use of harmful materials, that is, green IT. It will promote reusing of the existing resources instead of opting for buying a new one. So this leads to a decrease in the amount of harmful materials that is used for manufacturing various computing devices. Green IT will cause the reduction in the power and resource consumption as it promotes power management features, cloud computing, telecommuting and video conferences. It improves the operational efficiency. As a result of this, there is a reduction in energy and resource consumption. The total cost saving occurs, as there will be a considerable amount of reduction in electricity bills, and also recycling will reduce the cost of raw materials that is used in manufacturing process of an IT hardware. Green IT, it will meet the sustainable demands of the customer and the employees, as there is a decrease in the overall cost. So all these benefits will act as a driving force for an enterprise to go green its infrastructure with the hopes to achieve all or at least few of these benefits. ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ನ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಏನೇನು ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮಗೆ ಈ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐ ಟಿ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೋ ಆಗ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐ ಟಿ. The second one is social, cultural and political influence. As we are living in a society, we cannot run our business as if we are caring for nothing. There is a social responsibility on every individual and on every enterprise along with their business. So letting a lot of pollutants into the atmosphere will hinder a company's image in the society. If the image of the company is spoiled, then the customer and the other organizations will not at all turn to them that will actually lead to a lower market stock. So in order to have a profitable business, a company needs to maintain a good image in the society. This good image can be achieved by doing various social works that would actually save our environment. So in the previous session, I told you all, if a company or an enterprise is located somewhere in the city limits, then the amount of pollution that is caused by that enterprise or the company will get noticed by the people as well as the concerned authorities, which will actually result in canceling their license or making them forcefully do green IT in order to sustain in their corporate market. I also gave you all the cracker manufacturing example. Since crackers are manufactured just because to celebrate, that is during Deepavali, so the amount of toxic materials that are used in that crackers is limited or restricted by few legislatory regulations that are framed by the government. So these regulations will definitely force any enterprise or the company to think of or to practice green IT in their infrastructure. The third one is industry and business pressures. In this competitive business, every enterprise will look for various innovative ways in order to make profit. The customers will definitely compare their products with the products of different manufacturers before they purchase and prefer to opt eco-friendly products which consume less energy but give better performance. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ನ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಮುಂಚೆ ಈಗ ನಾವೇ ಆಗಲಿ ಒಂದು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಇಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಅಂದಾಗ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ಕಡೆ ನಾವು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಯಾವ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅದರಿಂದ ಆದಷ್ಟು ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸೇವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವುದು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವ್ದು ಎಕೋ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಈ ತರ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಅನಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ದೇ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಪ್ರಿಫರ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕೋ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರರ್ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ನ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅದು ಸೇಲ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಇಮೇಜ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಆ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು green your infrastructure and if you focus on your business along with saving your environment. So in order to build a good image in the market and to make good profit, the enterprises, they'll green their existing infrastructure, their design, their manufacturing processes, the way they dispose the unused computing resources and many more. Fourth one is the regulatory and compliance requirements. There is a increase in the carbon footprint in the atmosphere due to increased greenhouse gas emissions. Hence, government formulates different regulations and the standards and also the directives in order to save our environment. When the government makes any regulations or any rules or any policies, it is the responsibility of every citizen and every enterprise or an organization to obey those rules and regulations. In this way, the enterprises may be forced to green their IT even if they are not interested to do so. The fifth factor or the fifth driving force for an enterprise to go green is the environmental concerns. There is a lot of climatic changes that occur due to greenhouse gas emissions into the environment. So, if the owner or the manufacturer has little concern for saving the environment for their future generations, then that would actually act as a driving force for an enterprise to do green IT. The sixth
driving force is the economical savings. As I already told you, are the benefits of green IT. So green IT will actually reduce the energy consumption, will increase the energy efficiency, will reduce the greenhouse gases, will reduce the carbon footprint, will actually reduce the operational cost. So all these benefits, they actually result in saving money or resulting saving investment for the enterprise or the company. So we can achieve energy efficiency, operational efficiency by reusing and recycling methods also. So if you reuse the existing computing resource, then the amount of money that is spent on purchasing a new computing resource would be reduced. And also recycling method, instead of just dumping the electronic device which is not in use, if you can dispose it to the e-collectors, they may send to the manufacturers who may recycle those products by taking the working parts of that particular device and using it for the new device, or by making few changes in that device to make it work properly, and again they may release it into the market for reselling. All these processes, they'll actually contribute to saving money or saving investment. So the total cost savings, they'll occur as there will be a considerable amount of reduction in electric bills, and also the amount of raw materials that is used will also get reduced, and the cost of cost for purchasing those raw materials will also get considerably reduced, thereby saving some amount of monetary status to the enterprises or the company. So what are the different approaches an enterprise uses for greening their information technology or for greening their infrastructure? There are three main approaches. One is tactical incremental approach. The second one is strategic approach. Third one is deep green approach. In the first tactical incremental approach, the existing IT infrastructure is retained as it is. After that, a few changes is made into the existing environment. A few easy measures are deployed into it in order to achieve reasonable green goals, such as dropping energy consumption. So what are those easy measures that could be applied into the existing system? You can enable the power management features. You can turn off all the computing resources that are idle at any point of time. That would actually reduce the amount of energy consumption. So also by using energy efficient lightings like LED lights, that will also reduce the consumption of energy. And by maintaining optimal room temperature. So if the temperature of a space is maintained moderately, then there would be no necessity for the usage of air conditioners or coolers that would actually release a lot of chlorofluorocarbons or greenhouse gases that would actually pollute the environment. The second one is strategic. In this strategic approach, an enterprise will conduct deep inspections of its IT infrastructure, and it will check how it works from the green viewpoint. So it will check for the loopholes, if any found in that system. If any loopholes found, then they'll try to correct them in order to contribute towards saving the environment. It then develops full plan addressing major aspects of greening its infrastructure. It then deploys new energy efficient environmental friendly computing systems. It actually develops and also implements new policies or new rules for obtaining and for using and for disposing various computing resources.
The primary aim of this approach is to reduce the overall carbon content in the atmosphere and also to reduce the cost to a considerable amount. It focuses on the marketing side also in order to create a good image in the society. The last one is the deep green approach. In this approach, in addition to the existing infrastructure, they actually adopt few extra measures like growing trees and by using electrical power that is generated by renewable sources of energy like solar and wind energy. They actually contribute to greening the environment with the intention to deactivate the greenhouse gas emissions and the carbon footprint in the environment. And the next thing that we discussed in the last session is the greenwashing. Greenwashing, it actually refers to the practices of an organization making deceptive statements, showing deceptive actions or the procedures, and then green certificates which are not valid, and their false claims to earn profitable business in the competitive business market. Here, an organization will simply spend money and the time on advertisements and marketing that it is manufacturing eco-friendly products and it has so many eco-friendly procedures that it is following, and also it claims that it has registered to various standards, Green IT standards, and also claims that it produces the products which are more energy efficient and so on and on. But the fact is different. It is just showing off that it is implementing green business practices that minimizes the environmental impact. The organization is actually fooling the people by just appearing to be a green company. But it is not a green company, but it only claims to be a green company. It tries to fool the customers and the other organizations. And there are a lot of benefits in doing this green washing by a company. So it is actually fooling the customers and other companies, but it is a benefit for that company who is doing greenwashing, because the customers get fooled by seeing their advertisements. They end up buying their products, which results in higher stock price for an organization, and the other green organization may feel their pleasure to get tie up with these organizations for their business expansion, but actually they also get fooled thinking that these are green, but actually they are not green. They just fool all the customers and the organizations just to make money, just to increase their market value. It's a socially careless and bad practice. It's a bad marketing trick to establish an eco-friendly image to the customers. ಬರೀ ನಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಆ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ನ ನಾವು ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನಾವು ಆ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಗೆ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟು, ನಾವು ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನಾವು ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಸೇವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನಮ್ಮದು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಇಷ್ಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದೆ, ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಮ್ಮದು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಎಕೋ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಡ್ವರ್ಟೈಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ಕೋಬೋದೇ ವಿನ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಅದು ಮಾಡಿರಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಆಗ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬೇರೆ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಲೇಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ನಾವು ಈ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಈ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟನ್ನು ಆದಷ್ಟು ಸೇವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಆದಷ್ಟು ನಮ್ಮ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕನ್ಸಂಪ್ಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ಮ ಓವರಾಲ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಆದಷ್ಟು ನಾವು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೋದು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇಂಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ವಾಷಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇಂಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಟು ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವೆದರ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬರ್ಡನ್ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ. So, greening IT will contribute a lot of benefits like lessening the energy consumption, saving the overall operational energy and reducing the cost. Reducing greenhouse gases reduces carbon footprint. It also reduces the amount of money spent on the raw materials, etc., etc., etc. So when it gives a lot of benefits, how can we think it as a burden? So it could definitely be an opportunity for any enterprise or for any company to get that opportunity or to get that chance to save the environment through greening IT. So the green philosophy, the Go Green movement, and the green demands on the corporate IT, they do not burden the IT systems, corporate IT departments, or the functional units. These initiatives will provide an opportunity to revisit and to examine our IT systems and the operations that are carried out within the IT systems in terms of energy efficiency and resource utilization. This will help to minimize the IT's energy consumption and also to save on the energy bills. So, going green will include improving the energy efficiency, improving the resource utilization. It also includes reducing the waste. It actually promotes reuse and recycling and more such benefits. Going green will give the necessary motivation in order to turn the IT green and the use IT in innovative new ways in order to green all other corporate functions. So the implications of not going green, it might cost a lot to the enterprise or the company. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಅಥವಾ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸು ಇಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದೂ ಅದನ್ನು ಬರ್ಡನ್ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅವ್ರು ಏನಾದರೂ ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ದೆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ತುಂಬ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ, ತುಂಬ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಗೇನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅವರು. ಸೊ ದ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಾಂಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಮರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟರ್ environmental regulations, stakeholder demands, competitiveness, brand or corporate image, and social responsibility. ಇದೆಲ್ಲನೂ ಅವ್ರು ಕಾಂಪ್ರಮೈಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೇಸ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸಿಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದೋಸ್ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸ್ಟೇಕ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಯಾರೇ ಬೇರೆ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ನ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಗೆ ಇಂಥದೇ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದೊಂದು ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಹೇಗೆ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಗಳು ಕೂಡ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ನೆಸ್, ಸೊ ನೀವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ಗಳು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐ ಟಿ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೋ ದೇಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗುಡ್ ರೆಪ್ಯುಟೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್. ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ ಇಮೇಜ್. So if you are doing green IT in your infrastructure, then you will be having a lot of benefits, including the customers getting attracted towards your green eco-friendly products that will actually improve your business and also create a good image in the market. The customers will start thinking, we can trust this particular company without a second thought. And also every enterprise or the company will have some social responsibility. You can run a company or you cannot run an enterprise just to make money. So when you are living in a society, when you are living with the people who actually contribute to your success, it is your responsibility to make some works that actually help the surrounding environment. A holistic and objective view would reveal green IT, that is greening of IT and greening by IT. So greening of IT ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇರುವಂತ ಇನ್ಫ್ರಾಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ನ ಅಥವಾ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ಐಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಎರಡು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿನ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಹೋಲಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವ್ಯೂ ವುಡ್ ರಿವೀಲ್ ದಟ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐಟಿ, ವಿಚ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೀನಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ಐಟಿ, ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ನೆಸೆಸಿಟಿ. ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನೆವರ್ ಬಿ ಅನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸೂನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ನೆಸೆಸಿಟಿ. ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಒನ್ ಫೀಲ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಬರ್ಡನ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಗೋ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯೇಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸೇವಿಂಗ್ ಅವರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ಸ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಅವೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐಟಿ ಗಿವ್ಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಟು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಐಟಿ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ, ನಾಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಬರ್ಡನ್. Green IT will be a priority for several years as it is both an economic and environmental imperative. The greening efforts reveal that the businesses that reduces their environmental carbon footprint can also reduce the cost and improve their public image. The green initiatives, they're catching the attention of the corporate world. So the green philosophy, it is not at all a burden. It should be always treated as an opportunity. The green initiatives will let us revisit and examine our existing IT systems and their operations in terms of energy efficiency and resource utilization, and thus can reduce the energy bills of that particular company or an organization. So till now a very little attention was given to IT's energy consumption, effective use of resources, operational costs and negative environmental impacts during manufacturing, use and disposal. But now a spotlight has been turned on information technology, and there is a pressing need to address these overlooked aspects which are important in safeguarding the environment for future generations. So the Go Green philosophy, actually it is not a burden, it is an opportunity, as it enables, it actually leads to improving the energy efficiency, improving the resource utilization. It also leads to reducing the waste that is released into the environment. It also promotes the reuse and recycling, thereby reducing the amount spent on the purchase of the raw materials. And it also minimizes the energy consumption and it saves the energy bills. It also focuses on the creation of more sustainable environment. As I already told, a spotlight has been turned on the information technology, and there is a very urgent need, very immediate need to address the IT's energy consumption, the effective use of resources and operational costs. These are the overlooked aspects of green IT, and they are important very much in safeguarding the environment for future generations. The smart companies, they'll adopt an environmental strategy in order to innovate, create value and build a competitive advantage. This will benefit by viewing these challenges as strategic opportunities. Again, the greening of IT and greening by IT will soon be a necessity, but it will never be an option in future. In order to help create a more sustainable environment, IT professionals must understand green IT and its potential and should keep contributing with new tools and new systems for reducing the greenhouse gases emissions into the environment, thereby reducing the carbon footprint that would actually save our environment and the entire whole planet for the future generations. So next, we'll have a few multiple choice questions and assessment. In that first question, an approach in which an enterprise uses existing IT infrastructure. So this is all discussed in the last session. So greening IT will actually deal with all those approaches and methodologies. So we'll discuss on the few MCQs which are related to the previous sessions also. An approach in which an enterprise uses the existing IT infrastructure. So tactical uses the already existing infrastructure. Strategic will clearly inspect the existing infrastructure and make changes in order to go green. Deep green will actually adopt few extra measures for going green. So which uses the existing system is the tactical approach. So the answer for this question is tactical. The primary motive of strategic approach. So what is the intention of the strategic approach? The main intention is to reduce the carbon and also to reduce the cost. So the carbon content should be reduced and also the overall cost should be dropped down. So the out of these three options, that is reduce carbon footprint, option B energy efficiency, option C reduce toxic chemicals, the first option, that is reduce carbon footprint, would be the correct answer. So pretending to be a green company. So green company in the sense doing all the green IT activities in order to save the company. Company or an organization, and in turn saving the environment. So pretending to be a green company. So you're actually not a green company, but you pose as if you are a green company. So that is nothing but green washing. So the answer for this question is green washing. Fourth one is DASH is the lead free directive. So we have discussed a few green IT standards and eco-labeling of infrastructure. So out of those standards, seven standards which we had discussed, which is a lead-free directive. So WEEE, it deals with the disposal of the electrical equipments, how you recycle them, how you take back. And Energy Star will deal with the amount of energy consumed by the electronics. ROHS, it actually restricts the amount of hazardous substances in any product. So lead is an hazardous substance. So lead free, it is, that is restricting lead in any manufacturing process that is done by ROHS. The correct answer for this is ROHS. The voluntary declarations of energy consumption. So it is a requirement of EN 16001, option B ISO 14001, option C Energy Star. So EN 16001 and ISO 14001, they actually deal with the energy management systems. Energy Star is the one which actually forces any manufacturer to disclose or to give a information regarding the amount of energy that is consumed by that product or the amount of energy that could be saved using that product. So the option C, that is Energy Star, is the correct answer for this question. And sixth one, DASH is the probability of occurrence of a problem. So auditing, as I already told you all in the previous sessions, auditing is nothing but physical checking or cross-checking or verifying the authenticity of any document that has some data. Checking for the correctness of that document. So risk is nothing but it is a problem that may occur or may not occur. Disaster, it is a problem that is out of control. Degradation is the reduction in the quality. So therefore, risk, the option B, risk is the correct answer. That is nothing but the probability of occurrence of a problem. Seventh one, combining one or more environmental monitoring networks is called. So modeling is pictorial representation of the analysis. Integration is combining. Optimization is making more effective. Interoperability is creating dependency between any two systems. So integration will bring the notion of combining. So therefore, combining one or more environmental monitoring networks is called integration. So the correct answer is option B, integration. So the transformation of physical goods into information goods is called option A, dematerialization, option B, interoperability, option C, integration, option D, optimization. Option A, dematerialization, that is, there are physical goods which you convert it into information goods. Interoperability is making the data available for other systems. Integration is combining one or two systems. Optimization is making a system more effective. So the option A, dematerialization, is nothing but the transformation of physical goods into information goods. So you can have a discussion on few descriptive questions. What is meant by greenwashing? Explain with example. So greenwashing and theledre, just claiming to be green. Actually green agiralla. Actually green activities na implement maadkondiralla. Bari advertising maado antadu, bari posing maado antadu, bari show off maado antadu, that I am performing various green activities in my company or an organization. So, I am contributing to saving the environment. Anta ondu show off maado anta process na now greenwashing anta karitivi. So, explain the driving forces for an enterprise to do green. So, as we discussed in the first section of this session, that is self-interest, social, cultural and political influences, regulations that are made by the government, economic savings, and industry and the business pressures. These are all the driving forces for an enterprise to do green. So you have to explain each one of them in detail. Justify whether green IT is a burden or an opportunity. So by this time, you people might be very clear about what is green IT and what are the techniques that are used for greening an IT and how a green IT could be used for greening some other systems in order to achieve environmental sustainability. You might be knowing the benefits of going green, what all benefits you get, how you can reduce your cost, how you can reduce your energy, all these factors you'll be knowing. So after knowing all these, you will be able to justify whether it is a burden or an opportunity. I would definitely treat it as an opportunity because it will allow you to revisit your entire system to check how much emissions the system is doing into the environment and how the computing resources are not properly efficiently used, how they are made energy inefficient, how the energy consumptions are simply going on and on and on without any restrictions. All these factors we'll get to know. So since it gives us all these benefits and opportunities, it is definitely a opportunity, not a burden. Even if you treat it as a burden, the government and the regulations and the standards that have been set up will definitely make you feel it is a opportunity. You have to definitely take it as an opportunity and perform green IT activities. Even if you think of it as a burden, you're not supposed to let it go. You have to do it. So green IT, it is an opportunity. So for any extra information, you can go through this book, Harnessing Green IT Principles and Practices, written by San Murugesan and G.R. Gangadharan. And you can also go through the book written by Kashinath Bidre, that is Green Computing book. So this would give me immense pleasure to again thank all of these contributors who have been giving me immense support, suggestions and motivations, and encouraging me for developing all this e-content for fifth semester computer science students. Thank you so much. Thank you one and all.